Thank you for watching us on YouTube. But did you know that if you're on the go, you can get the full show as a podcast now? You can get our morning breakdown of the most important topics facing our country, news not being covered by the mainstream media, interviews with change-making progressives, and info on what you can actually do about all this. Search for The Damage Report on your favorite podcast app and subscribe so you know when new episodes are ready to go. I do want to talk about what do Republicans think so far about the testimony? We have a few indications. First from Fox News, I thought this was interesting. David Mack, I believe, is with BuzzFeed News, had a tweet. On Fox News, Brett Baer says that hearing from Blasey Ford is, quote, a totally different thing than reading her allegations. And Chris Wallace says, quote, this was extremely emotional, extremely raw, and extremely credible. This is a disaster for the Republicans.
Chris Wallace also talked about how his own daughters felt comfortable coming forward and talking about their experiences after Christine Blasey Ford, went public with her allegations. I actually give Chris Wallace and to some degree Brett Baer some credit because they are in this highly politicized, pro-conservative bubble.
Yeah.
And anytime anyone tries to deviate from that, there seems to be consequences. And they were still willing to do the right thing. And so even though I disagree with them on a lot of things, I have to give them credit for at least being honest in regard to the hearing.
Well, that's why we always give so much credit to Shep Smith when he's willing to, like we know, and by the way, I think it might have been Chris Wallace said something that was critical of Trump months ago and just got demolished by the Fox News audience because unfortunately, like people just have this like they're worshipers of a god. Like that's their view of these people. And to some extent that applies to these people when they're talking to people who love Trump. Like there's no thinking really, there's no critical analysis. If you disagree with me 1%, I will set you on fire. That seems to be the view. I was on Larry King yesterday and there was a congressional candidate, a Republican in New York, who seemed reasonable. She said a few things that were critical of Donald Trump, and I thanked her for being willing to do that because it's so rare. And because in these primaries, people who did not just cling on to Donald Trump got beat by people who did.
I know.
And that's not what our country needs. But speaking of Trump, Gabriel Sherman tweeted, person close to Trump says Trump is raging about how bad this has been for Republicans so far. Trump told people Ford, quote, seems credible.
Right.
Also later on, Trump telling people he's furious that White House aides didn't have advanced knowledge of how credible Ford would seem. That's an amazing statement. How credible she would seem. As if like whether this happened to her or didn't happen to her has nothing to do with it. It's all a performance, it's all TV. I mean, we've seen that he talks about like someone looks like they come from central casting. It's all this facade. There's nothing underneath it.
Right.
She was sexually assaulted. Thus, her talking about it is gonna seem kind of credible.
You know, one of the things that I found interesting was how unprepared Republicans in the Senate Judiciary Committee seem, Chuck Grassley in particular, because you know, the hearing began with Chuck Grassley and Dianne Feinstein reading their statements, their opening statements.
Yeah.
Chuck Grassley seemed as though he was reading a statement that had been prepared for him and that he had been reading it for the first time. He was tripping up all over the words. Mm-hmm. It almost seemed like, of course, I think he knows how to read, but it almost seemed like he was having trouble reading. Whereas Dianne Feinstein, and I've been a critic of hers in the past,
but
Dianne Feinstein, to her credit, read that opening statement and did so in a powerful way. Mm-hmm. She came prepared. It seems as though the Democrats came prepared. What I'm looking forward to is seeing Kamala Harris conduct her line of questionings because she is very powerful and strong when it comes to, you know, situations like this. So we'll see.
Yeah, and also, I mean, as much as I'm looking forward to her talking to Christine Blasey Ford, I mean, her talking to Brett Kavanaugh.
That's what I'm looking forward to the most. I'm just gonna keep
it
real.
That's gonna be something.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, all of them, but especially Kamala Harris. And I will also say, I was very critical of Dianne Feinstein when this story was initially coming out. When we found out that there was some sort of accusations and then we found out what they were. It sure seemed like Dianne Feinstein was just willing to go along with whatever was happening and why even bring it up.
Yeah.
But now after hearing Christine Blasey Ford explain it, I mean, I might disagree with what Dianne Feinstein did, but she seemed to have done what Christine Blasey Ford wanted her to do.
I actually think the way Dianne Feinstein handled it, based on Blasey Ford's testimony, she did the right thing.
Yeah. So I was wrong, and I'm willing to admit that. Thank you very much for watching this clip from the Damage Report. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell on YouTube to get notifications of our new videos. And of course, you can catch the full Damage Report live every weekday at 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific on TYT Network on YouTube TV.